VBA. Control shift enter or a macro way. Well, there's Mike G on the CSE. Billy J getting down with the VBA. Oh my, it's a Dueling Excel guy. Stand by, it's a Dueling Excel guy. Slama, it's Dueling Excel time.
Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is our episode 170. Put an apostrophe before every number. All right, today's question sent in by Michael. Michael has 20,000 rows of data, and over in column A is an asset ID. He needs to send this data from Excel into some other software, and the importer for that software is expecting an apostrophe before the asset ID. And before I jump into how to solve this, let's talk about that apostrophe for a second. I'm just going to go to a new workbook here. Of course, if we type in 123, it's a number, but if we do apostrophe 123, that tells Excel, don't treat this as a number, treat this as text. I'm going to do two other ones. This goes back to the days of Lotus 123. The caret used to center the number, and the quotation mark used to right justify the number. Now, it appears here that Excel has only picked up the apostrophe, but really, really obscure. If we go to File, and then Options, and then Advanced, and then in Advanced, I'm going to go all the way down to the very bottom, third from the bottom, Transition Navigation Keys, turn that back on for Lotus compatibility, then the 123, of course, works. Apostrophe 123 still works. Caret 123 also starts to work, and quotation mark 123 will work as well. So that's interesting. Well, it's interesting in kind of the Cliff Clavin kind of way. I don't think anyone would ever turn on the formula evaluation keys just to be able to have a quick way to left or center or right justify. But it makes me wonder, when I see Michael's question, if this goes back to the days, if this import software was written back in the days of Lotus 123, when that apostrophe was used to denote a text cell. I'm guessing, Michael didn't say this, that he has to export to a CSV, and that apostrophe must get exported out there. So how am I going to solve this? I'm going to go to VBA, Alt F11. I'll insert a module, and these three tiny lines of code here, for each cell in selection, the cell.formula is equal to, in quotes, an apostrophe, ampersand, cell.value, and then next, right? Alt F11 to go back to Excel. I'm going to assign it to a shortcut key, so Alt F8 will get me a list of all my macros. There's my macro called Add It, Options. I'm just going to do Control T for text, even though that already makes things into a table. This is, you know, kind of a one-time use thing, and then it'll go away. All right, so all I have to do then is select my range of cells, Control Shift Down Arrow, and press Control T, and just like that, we've added the apostrophe. All right, Mike, let's see what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Oh, VBA. You know, before Excel 2013, I don't even know how I would have done this without VBA. But watch this, Excel 2013 rocks. I'm going to Alt-I-C to insert a column, right arrow, Control-C, left arrow, Control-V, down arrow. And watch this, apostrophe, and I'm looking at the number 90513, enter, apostrophe, and you are not going to believe this. Flash fill picks it up. If I hit enter, I will accept this ghost list, enter. Now, flash fill doesn't work for everything, but control down arrow, if you look at every single one is exactly perfect. Control home, because if you're doing something simple like inserting a character with these five numbers to the right, it works perfectly. Now, right arrow and Alt ED for delete, C for column, and enter. There you go. Throw it back to Mr. Excel.
Hey, that's brilliant. Like flash fill. Of course, you have to have a heading up there. The heading can be anything you want, and then any text. And that number 90513. But I was surprised that it worked for you, because Chad at Microsoft, who worked on flash fill, says that he doesn't like to automatically do flash fill for numbers, because it's too hard for Excel to get confused. And sure enough, it's not kicking in here. But when it doesn't kick in, and you know that it should be able to kick in, just go to that cell and do Control E, and they will fill down. There you go, a couple of cool different ways to solve this problem. Well, thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.